Okay, we're doing the golden ratio and Fibonacci numbers, and I'm going to show you why Lucas numbers are better than Fibonacci numbers. So,
haven't you already done that?
You know, it does sound familiar, doesn't it? Because we did a video a couple of years ago now about Lucas numbers, which Lucas numbers, instead of starting 1-1 Fibonacci, they start 2-1, and then they carry on from there. Then you get 3-4. I just put a couple of them down here, so we've got a couple of Lucas numbers to get us going. Okay, that's... And then the Fibonacci numbers, which everyone already knows and loves. If you line them up here, instead of going 1-3, you can think of Fibonacci as the 1-1. And then you get 2, 3, 5, 8, and so on, 13. People love the Fibonacci numbers because they're just lots of cool things, and they have the constant ratio that, as if you multiply one to get to the next one, it's the golden ratio as your multiplier as you go down. Well, not exactly, but it tends to the golden ratio. And what I pointed out in our previous video is Lucas numbers do that as well. So again here, the ratio from one to the next approaches the golden ratio. In fact, any sequence where you start with two numbers and then add them to get the next one and repeat always approaches the ratio of the golden ratio. And so—
Even the Brady numbers.
So if you wanna, that was the origin of the Brady numbers to prove that point. There's a video where I prove it algebraically and we look at these and they're absolutely great. And the kind of the crux of my argument as to why Lucas is better than Fibonacci is if all these Fibonacci-esque sequences have that property, what happens if we start with the golden ratio as the ratio and then work out what sequence drops out? And so what I did was show that if you take the golden ratio and square it, you get 2.618 dot dot dot, which if you round it to the nearest whole number is 3. And I'm not going to do all of them again this time, as you can see what's going on here. If you cube it, you get 4.236 dot dot dot, which if you round it to the nearest whole number is 4, and you go, that's looking familiar. 5, it equals 11.090 dot dot dot, which is approximately 11, right? And so it turns out that the Lucas numbers are just the golden ratio raised to a power and then rounded, and use square brackets for rounded to the nearest whole value. And so the nth Lucas number in this sequence is just the golden ratio to that power rounded to the nearest whole number. And I'm like, boom, that's why Lucas numbers are better, because if you start with a golden ratio and raise it to powers, what drops out? The Lucas numbers. Someone on the internet had a different opinion. Someone on Reddit with quite a new account, I think they've created it just to come and harass me with their proof, Zepoxy Pylon. They came at me and said, "Oh, Matt, if you raise the golden ratio to various powers, you don't get the Lucas numbers. In fact, you get a whole lot of Fibonacci numbers." And so what they did was use the fact that famously the golden ratio minus 1 equals 1 over the golden ratio. Lovely. I mean, I'm a huge fan of that, right? This is the stuff I do get excited about. You can actually multiply everything here by the golden ratio and shuffle it around a little bit, and you'll see the golden ratio squared equals the golden ratio plus 1, which is also love. So I'm stating the same thing. Very nice way. In fact, if you then solve this kind of quadratic equation, you can show that the golden ratio is the square root of 5 plus 1 on 2. And that's where the value comes from. But the interesting thing here is actually, I worked out the numerical value when I did the golden ratio squared. Why don't I do it in terms of the golden ratio? You know, why not keep it as you know, an exact number? Because if you recall correctly, Brady, you complained when I did this because I was rounding. You said it's not very precise, you know, it's a bit rough and ready.
This doesn't seem very much like a lot of the other mathematics I see. It seems kind of a bit fuzzy and almosty.
And so, fair enough. You know, now other people agree with you, I'm going to do it again and keep it in exact terms. So, this is where it starts to get interesting. Golden ratio squared equals golden ratio plus 1. Already know that. Okay. Golden ratio cubed equals, golden ratio cubed is the golden ratio squared times the golden ratio. We already know that that is the golden ratio plus 1, golden ratio. Golden ratio squared plus the golden ratio, but that equals the golden ratio plus 1. And so actually that's 2 golden ratios plus 1, once I simplify that down. Okay, here we go. 2 golden ratios plus 1. Okay, golden ratio to the power of 4. Well that's the same one from last time, but multiply it by another golden ratio. 2 golden ratio squared plus the golden ratio, but that is the golden ratio plus 1, so that's 2 golden ratios plus 2 plus that, 3 ratios plus 2. Okay, here we go. 3 ratios plus 2. Now, I don't know if you can see what's happening here, but if I carry this on, the next one, you do the same thing, you multiply it, you simplify it down. 5 golden ratios plus 3. Golden ratio to the power of 6 is 8 golden ratios plus 5. And sure enough, if you carry down this, you get the Fibonacci sequence here, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, and you get it here offset, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, and so on. And so the point that has been raised online is that actually, if you do what I do, but you don't do this ridiculous rounding, you keep it in exact golden ratios and simplify it, you get two lots of the Fibonacci sequence.
Burn, Matt.
Yeah, well played, internet. I see the error of my ways. I'm big enough to admit when I'm wrong. It's become a theme, it turns out. And you know what? I can't argue with that, right? So to celebrate the fact that someone's shown me that the Fibonacci numbers are the best by my own logic, let's do, you know, what we do to celebrate things in mathematics. We try to generalize them. So let's just generalize this up a little bit, right? And then we'll call it a day. If you look here, to the power of 3, because I said the nth Lucas number is the golden ratio to that power. So the nth is that to the n. And that's why I'm calling this as the first one. That's the second position, third position, fourth, fifth, sixth, and so on. And so here, the fifth, let's take the fifth for example. The fifth power of the golden ratio is the fifth Fibonacci number, because 5 is the fifth Fibonacci number, plus the one below it, the fourth one. And I quite like that. 5 is the only Fibonacci number which is equal to its position. Unnecessary side fact. And so if I want to generalize this, what I've actually got here is the golden ratio to n equals that Fibonacci number times the golden ratio plus the Fibonacci number before it. So f n minus 1. That's quite nice. So there you are. So we'll generalize the pattern with a look. Oh, we can probably simplify that actually because we've got a golden ratio here. And like we said, the ratio is always golden ratio as you go up. So f n times the golden ratio is actually just the next Fibonacci number. So actually that equals the Fibonacci n plus 1 plus f n minus 1. Oh, that's quite nice. So what I've been correctly schooled on is that the golden ratio to n is the Fibonacci number after n and the Fibonacci before n summed together. That is very, very pleasing. But actually, we could probably add them together, couldn't we? Because we can simplify this, right? Because it's always the Fibonacci number ahead and the one behind summed together. So let's just, very quickly, I'm going to list out the Fibonacci numbers again. 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21. And then we'll add the, for every position, before and after. So 1 and 3, if we add those together, we get, 1 and 2, we get 3. If we add 1 to 3, we get 4. If we add 2 to 5, we get 7. 3 to 8, we get 11. 5 to 13, we get 18. And then we can carry on all the way up. So if you do generalize this and simplify it down, and then you add the offset Fibonacci numbers, you get this sequence here, which is, of course, the Lucas number. Oh my goodness, where did that come from? So there you are. So yes, if you follow the proxy pylons method, you do get the Fibonacci sequence popping out twice. You get two of them, one in each direction. But that's because if you sum the Fibonacci numbers ahead with Fibonacci numbers behind, you get the Lucas numbers. And so it still is the Lucas numbers. You've just split it into two Fibonacci numbers. But that, and no rounding, that is the exact, okay, there was some rounding, but I hit it. That is the exact Lucas numbers coming out the other side. You look unconvinced, Brady.
You know what I say?
Yep.
Boom. Proxy pylon.
Oh, really? Yeah. That
burn.
Time.
You burned
boom.
Him.
There it is. We
you,
did it.
You burned him. I,
you know, it was a solid mass burn. You know, I should give him directions to the nearest maths department. What? To be honest, they can probably come back with yet another argument for why it's Fibonacci, because it turns out the two sets of numbers are very closely linked. And the fact that you can sum pairs of one and you get the other one, that is why I can flip backwards and forwards between these, almost at will. And where the rounding's gone, because you think, well, hang on, I've just done what I did before, but now the rounding's disappeared. All the rounding was hidden in this step here. That's where the rounding was, when I went from there to there. Because it's not actually the golden ratio between consecutive terms, it approaches it. And so eventually it's that exactly, but initially you got to round for that to happen. And that's why you're rounding over here to get this. So that's where all the rounding has been swept under that one step there. And so you still get the numbers out. So thank you, Zipoxy Pylon, for getting involved. And it was a very nice argument. You had me worried for a while, but I'm glad I could sit down, and the fact that I could generalize their argument to loop back to mine, that is immensely pleasing.
Well, you think this is over, do you?
I think, this round is over, but, I throw the gauntlet down or out or across, I forget the relevant direction, and if the people of the internet, the netizens, want to rise up and present yet another counter-argument, I am ready.
Hi everyone, you might be unsurprised to know that Matt has a bit more to say on the subject, in fact, about 8 minutes more. It turns into a bit of a philosophical discussion about the square root of 5. And if you'd like to see that continuation, I'm going to post it on our Numberphile 2 channel. But you don't have to wait for it to go public there. There are links to the video right now on the screen and in the video description. There's also more stuff in the description about Matt's work and what he's up to these days.
So let's just roll this up. People will sing odes and tell tales of the day I felled Zproxy Pylon and their attack on the king.